大家好，我是 Stella，
我是温蕊。今天要为你念的是《奇迹众文》第四章《小我的幻象》Chapter 4 The Illusions of the Ego 第五节《小我及身体的幻象》The Ego Body Illusion。
世间万物同心协力，纯粹是为人类的益处。All things work together for good. 此言不虚，绝无例外，除非你听信了小我的判断。There are no exceptions except in the ego's judgment. 小我殚精竭虑地把守意识的门槛，只允许它认可之物进来，这绝不是保持心灵平衡之道。The ego exerts maximal vigilance about what it permits into awareness, and this is not the way a balanced mind holds together. 小我不让你意识到他最深的动机，他为了掌控你，不仅压制你清明的神智，而使得小我的处境更为失衡。The ego is thrown further off balance because it keeps its primary motivation from your awareness and raises control rather than sanity to predominance. 小我这种作风有他不得已的苦衷，因他受制于那营造小我且要他效命的整套思想体系。The ego has every reason to do this, according to the thought system which gave rise to it and which it serves. 神智清明的判断必然与小我的判断背道而驰，小我为了维护自身的利益，不得不将它斩草除根。 Same judgment would inevitably judge against the ego and must be obliterated by the ego in the interest of its self-preservation. 构成小我处境失衡的主因在于它无法分辨身体与上主圣念之间的差异。 A major source of the ego's off-balanced state is its lack of discrimination between the body and the thoughts of God.小我无法接受上主的圣念，因为他公然指出小我不存在这一事实。 Thoughts of God are unacceptable to the ego because they clearly point to the non-existence of the ego itself. 因此小我不是加以扭曲，便是全力抵制。 The ego therefore either distorts them or refuses to accept them. 但它消灭不了上主的圣念。 It cannot, however, make them cease to be. 为此小我只好改用隐藏策略，不只藏起它难以认同的身体本能，连上主的圣念也一起打入了冷宫，因为两者对小我构成了同等的威胁。It therefore tries to conceal not only unacceptable body impulses, but also the thought of God, because both are threatening to it. 小我为了自身的存亡，不能不把两者都视为同一威胁。Being concerned primarily with its own preservation in the face of threat, the ego perceives them as the same. 唯有把他们打为一丘之貉，小我才能不受其害，否则真知一旦现前，小我便无立足之地了。By perceiving them as the same, the ego attempts to save itself from being swept away as it would surely be in the presence of knowledge. 只有神智失常的思想体系才会把上主与身体混为一谈。Any thought system that confuses God and the body must be insane.然而这一混淆正是小我存在的核心， 他所有的判断都是根据有威胁或无威胁而定的。Yet, this confusion is essential to the ego, which judges only in terms of threat or non-threat to itself. 从某一方面来讲，小我对上主的恐惧可说是情有可原的，因为上主的观念确实否定了小我的存在。In one sense, the ego's fear of God is at least logical, since the idea of him does dispel the ego. 但是小我一样害怕自己密切认同的身体，且毫无道理可言。But fear of the body with which the ego identifies so closely makes no sense at all.身体是小我亲自选择的居所。The body is the ego's home by its own election. 唯有与身体认同，小我才有安全可言。因为身体的不堪一击，是它证明你不可能来自上主的最好证据。It is the only identification with which the ego feels safe.Since the body's vulnerability is its own best argument that you cannot be of God. 因此小我才会不遗余力地拥护这一信念。This is the belief that the ego sponsors eagerly. 然而小我又不能不痛恨身体，因为他认为身体不配作为他的居所。Yet,The ego hates the body because it cannot accept it as good enough to be its home. 这是心灵追赶茫然无措之处。Here is where the mind becomes actually dazed. 小我一边告诉自己我是身体的一部分，身体是我的保护者，一边又告诉自己身体无法保护我。Being told by the ego that it is really part of the body and that the body is its protector. The mind is also told that the body cannot protect it. 于是心灵不能不问，那么我应向哪儿寻求保护才对？ Therefore, the mind asks, Where can I go for protection? To which the ego replies,Turn to me. 心灵会理直气壮地反驳，小我一直强调自己和身体原是一物，求助于他的保护又有何用？ The mind, and not without cause, reminds the ego that it has itself insisted that it is identified with the body, so there is no point in turning to it for protection.小我对此直问哑口无言，因为他确实无言以对，但小我还有他最拿手的一招。The ego has no real answer to this because there is none, but it does have a typical solution. 他干脆把这问题由人性的意识中彻底抹去。It obliterates the question from the mind's awareness. 问题一旦被小我剔除于意识之外，人心只会感到一股无名的焦虑，但既然连反问的余地都没有，便也永无获得解答的机会了。Once out of awareness, the question can and does produce uneasiness, but it cannot be answered.Because it cannot be asked. 我应向哪儿寻求保护？这是你迟早都得提出的问题。This is the question that must be asked. Where can I go for protection? 圣经有言，你们去找，终会找到的。这并非叫你盲目的去找，拼命追求你根本认不得的东西。Seek and ye shall find.Does not mean that you should seek, blindly and desperately for something you would not recognize. 有意义的寻找需要意识清明的开始，意识清明的扯化，意识清明的前进。Meaningful seeking is consciously undertaken, consciously organized, and consciously directed.应先把目标界定清楚，而且矢志不移，须臾不忘才行。The goal must be formulated clearly and kept in mind. 学习不能没有真心想学的渴望。Learning and wanting to learn are inseparable.当你相信自己有心学习之物对你极其重要时，你的学习才会产生最佳效果。You learn best when you believe what you are trying to learn is of value to you. 然而，并不是你想学的每一件事情都具有持久的价值。However, not everything you may want to learn has lasting value.实际上，不少事情正因它们的价值短暂，你才会想要学它。Indeed, many of the things you want to learn may be chosen because their value will not last. 小我认为，不要投入任何涉及永恒的事物才是明智的选择，因为永恒之物必然来自上主。The ego thinks it is an advantage.Not to commit itself to anything that is internal, because the internal must come from God. 永恒性是小我一直想要开发的能力，结果一败涂地。Internalness is the one function the ego has tried to develop, but has systematically failed to achieve. 于是，小我只好在永恒的问题上头妥协，这是他面对任何真实问题时的一贯伎俩。The ego compromises with the issue of the internal, just as it does with all issues touching on the real question in any way. 他把注意力转向外在的事物，借此回避真正切身的问题，希望你从心底将它彻底忘怀。 By becoming involved with tangential issues, it hopes to hide the real question and keep it out of mind. 小我爱在琐碎事物上忙个不停，其目的不外乎此。 The ego's characteristic busyness with non-essentials is for precisely that purpose.小我存心阻碍心灵的学习进度，他最爱玩的把戏就是让你终日操心那些注定解决不了的问题。Preoccupations with problems set up to be incapable of solution are favorite ego devices for impeding learning progress.这种牵制战术使得深陷其中的人始终无暇反问一句，这究竟是为了什么？ In all these diversionary tactics, however, the one question that is never asked by those who pursue them is, what for? 日后，不论你碰到什么事情，都应学习如此反身自问。 This isThe question that you must learn to ask in connection with everything. 这究竟是为了什么? What is the purpose? 不论目的为何，你都会身不由己地为它效力。 Whatever it is, it will direct your efforts automatically.目标一定等于决定了你未来的努力方向，除非你中途改变主意，否则你会一直受制于先前的决定。When you make a decision of purpose, then you have made a decision about your future effort, a decision that will remain in effect unless you change your mind.
奇迹正文第四章，小我的幻象 Chapter 4 The Illusions of the Ego 第五集，小我及身体的幻象 The Ego Body Illusion 愿大家有一个圣灵充满的一天阿们我爱你哟、哦